Good day friends, I'm Dr. A.S.K. Gupta and I'm going to talk to you about the Mega Cisterna Magna. Mega Cisterna Magna is a fluid filled space in the posterior cranial fossa. Some people call it as a normal variant, and you can see that this is the cerebellar hemisphere over here. This is another cerebellar hemisphere and this is the vermis. And over here you can see this is the fourth ventricle. And to diagnose Mega Cisterna Magna, it is very important that you demonstrate three important things. Both the cerebellar hemispheres, normal fourth ventricle and a normal vermis. In case the vermis is not well visualized, it means this, we might be dealing with a Dandy-Walker syndrome. Normally the width of the cisterna magna is not more than 10 millimeters, but in case it is more than 10 millimeters, we call it as a mega cisterna magna. Here the width of the mega cisterna magna in this case is 14 millimeters to 15 millimeters. So, usually it is said there is no follow-up is required and it is a normal variant, but the ultrasonologist is supposed to report the finding. Mega cisterna magna is usually an isolated finding, and in case it is isolated, then there is no follow-up required. Patient should be reassured, but it is something which is really, really very disturbing. And the other diagnosis which should be kept in the differential is the arachnoid cyst or the epidermoid cyst, which might be slightly difficult to diagnose, but the main important differential diagnosis is the Blake pouch cyst. But the Blake pouch cyst, as I said, will show a keyhole structure over here and associated hydrocephalus. The arachnoid cyst is not that symmetrically encircling the cerebellar hemispheres, and the epidermoid cyst is generally a hazy structure with some septae. It is usually hypoechoic, but the Blake pouch cyst is absolutely anechoic, but it has a keyhole appearance and associated hydrocephalus. Sometimes while measuring the Mega Cisterna Magna, there might be confusion, but a BPD-like view should be made, and you can measure it again and again and take the average of the readings. But a view in which the cerebral hemispheres are seen, the nuchal fold is seen, and the cisterna magna is seen could be a correct view, as in this case. Sometimes there may be confusion whether it is really Mega Cisterna Magna or not, but here there is no confusion because the CSF is extending the subarachnoid space around the cerebellar hemisphere. I hope we have been able to demonstrate a good case of Mega Cisterna Magna. In case you like our video, please do subscribe to our channel. Do not forget to press the like button and share the video among large number of your friends so that maximum number of people can be benefited. Thank you very much.